Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released the first public beta of iOS 17. And in this video, I wanted to show you how to install it step by step on your iPhone or iPad. Now, if we go to Settings and General and then Software Update, if you're already signed up for the iOS 16 public betas or earlier, you'll already see this here and be able to install it. Now, this public beta is free and available to everyone around the world at the same time, and it's available on the iPhone XS, XS Max, XR, and newer. Unfortunately, Apple dropped support for the iPhone 8, 8 Plus, and iPhone X with iOS 17, so if you have one of those devices, you won't be able to install it. Now, this is the same build as iOS 17 Beta 3 for developers and the re-release that was out yesterday, so it's the same build, it's just released a day later. Now, the first thing we want to do is sign up for the beta program. Go to your web browser, go to Safari, and then go to beta.apple.com or apple.com/beta. Scroll down and hit sign up. Once you've signed up, then you can sign in and install this. Now we'll sign in and you'll see there's a guide for beta software. Now Apple has changed how they do this from last year. There's no longer a profile available, so if you scroll down, it will give you more information about it and different steps. You'll also have the option to see more about iPadOS, macOS, tvOS, and watchOS, as well as HomePod software for betas. So you'll be able to get those. And now once you go to your software updates, it will just show up under settings. So you'll have this extra option here where you can select beta updates. If we go into this, you'll see that we have the option for iOS 16 public beta. And if you're a developer, you'll have all of the different options here. Now there are a few very important things you need to do before you install this. You need to have a backup, because if you're on iOS 16 and then you update to iOS 17, you won't be able to backup from iOS 17 backups. You need to use iOS 16 backups. So if you're using iCloud, it's pretty simple. Go to your settings, tap on your name at the top, scroll down to iCloud, tap on iCloud, and then go to iCloud Backup. Once you're in the iCloud Backup screen, go ahead and tap on Backup Now. Make sure you have a backup before updating to iOS 17. Now you may need more iCloud storage, and if you don't have that, you can purchase it here, or you can use a computer and backup there as well, whether that's Windows using iTunes or a Mac. If I plug it into the Mac, you can backup and then tap on Backup Now under Finder. Now, make sure you select encrypted if you want to actually restore all of your information using different passwords and more. That will actually help you get all of that information back and limit the amount of things you actually need to update and put in your username and password for. Once you've completed the backup, go into your settings, go to General, Software Update, make sure you're selected on the public beta, give it a moment, and then go ahead and update. So download and install, it will ask for your passcode. Enter that and it will begin to download. Now, once iOS 17 is installed, you'll have all of the new features with interactive widgets, the updates to music, and much more. However, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 17 public beta, well, there's a few things to be aware of. First, you won't be able to downgrade from iOS 17 to iOS 16 without using a Mac or Windows computer. You need a computer to downgrade, and I have a separate video that I released today showing you how to do that step by step. Also be aware that if you decide to install watchOS 10 Beta 1 or Public Beta 1, you will not be able to communicate with your phone if you decide to downgrade it from iOS 17 to 16. So you may want to hold off for that. You'll have to wait for the public version of watchOS 10 or actually bring it to Apple in order for them to downgrade it. There is no way to downgrade watchOS 10 to watchOS 9 after you've installed it without bringing it to Apple. Now with the betas, there will be bugs when using iOS 17. Beta 1 was pretty good, especially compared to previous years with iOS 16 Beta 1. Beta 2 and Beta 3 seem to improve quite a few different things, but that still doesn't mean it's perfect. There are a lot of bugs, that's part of testing, and for example, the notification bug is still there. It just sort of jumps around and isn't responding like you would expect. It's not super smooth. There's also been some issues with the keyboard, where sometimes the keyboard disappears. Maybe you go to Spotlight Search, you can't type. There's been some odd bugs here and there all over the place. Additionally, on top of that, this has been affecting battery life. Battery life has not been great with iOS 17, especially for me. If I go down to my battery, You'll see my battery health is actually at 92%. And while I typically say iOS betas do not affect battery health, they don't specifically affect it, but what they do is actually use more battery typically. And when they use more battery, it means you're charging more and then cycling your battery more. You'll see yesterday I had 3 hours and 38 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 2 minutes of idle time, and used almost 100% of my battery. Throughout the regular betas, developer betas, and since the public betas are the same thing, battery life just hasn't been great overall. So that's definitely something that you might want to consider if you want to install the betas. It just hasn't been great as far as that goes. Some apps seem to use a lot of power, other apps don't use as much, but there's definitely a battery impact in some way when you're using the betas, whether that's poor battery life or not. Now, if you are having bugs, you should be submitting them in the feedback app. So if we scroll over, go into feedback, make sure you go into feedback and submit the issues. This is very important so that Apple knows what issues are going on. There's also release notes in here that will tell you exactly what's going on as far as things they're aware of, as far as problems and more. So you can see known issues here. So you want to check and see if you're actually seeing the known issue here before you report it, as Apple may already be aware of it. If they're not, you can go ahead and submit feedback. So if you go back, tap on this little button here, and now you can submit feedback for the version you're running, iOS in this case, and then it will gather information from what it's actually using and get information about what the issue is, what areas you're seeing the issue with, and what type of feedback are you reporting. If you're having issues, make sure you submit that, and sometimes Apple even responds back and maybe works with you to get this resolved. So there's definitely some things there that I would recommend doing if you're having bugs regularly and they're not already mentioned in the release notes. Now, if you're wanting to switch from iOS 17 developer beta to public beta, that's pretty simple. However, it won't switch until the next beta update is available. So if you're already on iOS 17 beta 3 re-release, this is the same version, so it won't find a version to install. So if we go to settings, then we go back over to general, then software update, you'll see here, we'll give it just a moment. If you're on public beta or you're on developer beta, it will not find it. However, if we go into the beta updates, you'll see we're already on the public beta now, but if we want to switch to the developer beta and we're a developer, it will come out the next time the beta comes out. So beta 4, for example, just tap on it and switch. It's that simple. However, again, you would need a computer to downgrade and remove the beta if you want to do that. So that's how to install iOS 17 public beta, and the developer beta is very similar as well. Signing up for the developer beta at developer.apple.com. Now, I'll cover every single little feature change and update when the next beta comes out, and on the weekends with follow-ups talking about more features we found, how battery life is going, different bugs that we're experiencing, and more. So be sure to check back for that. If you have any other questions, though, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, it will be linked in the description as it always is. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.